everybody, welcome back.
Sup.
Moralists claim that this squalid story is a tragedy. But as the greedy and terminally stupid couple survives the precipitous reversal of their fortunes, which indeed resulted from their own wretched behavior, it's barely a cautionary tale.
Bring him something tasty for once. The seaweed's gone off, the lard is rancid, and that old boot won't last a week. A bit of cod or mackerel even, or bacon or bread or veg. Veg.
Right you are, my dear. A fish, by all means. Big. Big.
The fisherman hasn't recently caught anything but a cold. Still, he's happy. But this evidently being his lucky day, the hapless fisherman hooks a flounder who, wouldn't you know, is enchanted.
Return me to the water, and your wish is my command.
My wife wants a nice piece of fish to eat. But I'm sure she'd prefer a bigger, more pleasant domicile.
Throw me back. She shall have a castle.
The flounder was true to his word. A castle with 100 rooms and as many servants and indoor plumbing to boot stands where his hovel had been. His wife, swollen with pride, hardly blinks when told the castle is a gift from a fish.
Husband, ask your fish for a bigger edifice for my friends and a title to match the property.
If you don't ask, you don't get, my precious. I'll whisper a word in his shell like. I think he has ears.
He's just a messenger, see? No wants of his own, the pathetic sap. Thinks he can satisfy this lunatic battle axe's hankering for more stuff. Wrong!
I'm sorry to ask, but my wife wants you to upgrade the castle to a church, and she wants to be Pope. Order people around, wear a big hat, have one of the sticks with the curly thing and the funny robes and the colored windows and all of that. No.
You saved my life. I'll grant your request.
Pope? What was to become of the current one? And what did he think would happen to him when she's Pope?
And I bless you all and forgive you, everyone, except those who owe me money. Pay up and nobody gets hurt!
Be generous and compassionate, my love. You are Pope, after all.
I can't afford
to be compassionate. This is what happens
when a greedy
person becomes Pope.
Besides, that's not my job.
Yep.
I could be compassionate if I were like God. Tell your fish to make me like God, and then I'll show you compassion and mercy. And punishment when necessary!
Ah, well. She perhaps has not heard the popular saying that there is no God but God.
My wife, the Pope, would be like God. Make it happen.
And so I shall. Return home and see his will be done. She shall be unto God.
A distinct change in tone, no. But lost on the fisherman, I'm certain.
Life is so unfair. I just wanted to be God.
Could she can't be a god or a sound
Never
selfish
heard of
bitch.
Overreaching, selfish, vulgar, and profane. They wasted their chance to improve their lot. She demanded to be more than human. He did not dissuade her. But are they truly punished for their wicked pride? No! They don't have what they never had. Big deal! If you think that's pretty thin, too, play on.
Mm-hmm.
See, this is what it's
beyond
like.
Unrequited
the wife is
this
zap,
destitute
the fish
fisherman has little to offer his disgruntled wife.
Yep.
Shelter and meager sustenance from the sea are not enough for her. I'd have left the witch. Sickening, really. Let's make them appreciate what they don't have. Make it gross.
Let's move!
I still love how everything looks. Ooh. Good thing you weren't on that.
Yep.
Stop it! Robin' stompin' butt can good.
Did you know that I got a nosebleed last night?
What, hon?
Did I mention I had a nosebleed last night?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, I'm still spinning up one.
Chomp and stomp! Her true self exposed. She's kicked him out and is left with nothing but her amorphous desire for something, anything more.
Did she try out to the wolf?
The formerly luckless angler hooks a magic flounder and wishes on behalf of his wife, the grasping shrew, for a bigger house. How novel! The flounder swears he'll deliver, while hardly seeming to mind the hook piercing its sagging lip. Perhaps a bit of sand in that would improve the bite. Make it foul. Let's move!
It goes from milk to rum.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I wish we could make milk turn to rum.
You can just do that with Belle.
We turn Belle's milk into rum?
I mean, why not?
grim's stinky now. Stomp it!
Fish in the sky.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Well, this isn't my kind of beach. There are bitches.
Made a go boom. A vainglorious castle has replaced his dumpy domicile. Only thing more insipid than realized wishes are white weddings. Let's ruin this joint before I sicken up. Make it stinky. Let's move!
Okay, can't go to that squid.
What on?
I said, I hope that Cannon gets on, put onto that squid.
Yep.
Whoa! What the hell was that?
I have no idea.
Still cool though.
Yep.
Now I'm smelling.
See you later, bitch.
Now I'm gross.
Try to love that is giving out blood.
Yep.
Oh, there's a secret up there.
Oh, yeah.
Stomp it! All the stairs look like sharks.
Yep.
Stomp it! They're little goombas.
The castle did not slake her thirst for things. Who couldn't see that coming? Now she wants to be Pope. Though obviously several cards short of a full deck. Is she crazy enough to want that sort of power? Let's deprive her of what's left of her wits. Make it nasty. And stump. Rump and stump.
I love how all the fountains give out blood.
Yep.
Rump and stump and butt kicking good.
Ooh, she's my fat bitch.
Crazy yep. Now. Woohoo! Look at her go! My turn! My turn!
Hey, she empowered
the fisherman. Abject but willing slave to his wife's ambition, demands the papers. What can he have asked for her premature demand? Make it foul. Thank you.
Grim's gross. Now. Chomp and stump. Make it nasty. Stomp it! But stomp it!
Oh, I'm so dark.
It's starting to rain.
Yep.
Stomp it! Convert this all to trash and rubble!
This seems about true.
Yep.
The fisherman's home has morphed into a church. Oh. If you believe in organized religion, or a supreme being who cares about us, you might be moved. But as I don't, let's break down that door. Make it gross. Now, who's smelly? Stomp it! Be good. Oh, now I'm having a ball. I don't mind church so much after all. First the castle, now the church, and the bitch still isn't satisfied. Now she wants to be God. If only she knew what a boring job he has, she'd think twice. We're in church. Where's the guilt, the sin, the wrath? Let's make it biblical. Make it disgusting.
Mm-hmm.
stomp it! Butt stomp it! Climactic finale. I hope everyone dies in the end. The fisherman makes his final wish that his wife become unto God. I know where this is going, but I'll save the surprise. Make it nasty. Do it now. Now who's rotten? Stomp it! A secret no more! Thank you. come!
There we go.
Now I have another secret. Watery grave, the worst kind. Romping, stomping, but take it good.
The
fisherman was a dim-witted and pliant tool of his insatiable wife, and his weak character invited disaster. Their downfall loomed, one greedy want away. And we didn't have to wait long for the anvil to drop. Oops, got what they deserved, I say. The wife's taste ran to more anything. Food, money, stuff, whatever. The limp husband would do anything to appease her voracious appetite and unquenchable thirst. The moment he caught the magic flounder, it was enlisted in perpetual service to his wife's ruinous greed.
Spare me, and I promise to make you happy.
You'll have to do better than that. It's the missus you have to please. Anything less than riches will just piss her off. I might as well eat you now.
Done. She's wealthy. And, could you stick a plaster on my jaw?
Even poor as dirt, she treated her husband and her neighbors like dumb beasts.
If you worship me as the goddess I am, you can live in these fine new houses. If you don't, you can die. Slowly.
They thank you, your holiest, most revered, beneficent, and majestic one. They are grateful. As am I.
Besides chill blades, pimples, heretics, and stomach gas, talk is the thing most not worth having more of!
She wants a cathedral this time, with accoutrements, she says, and she insists that she be Pope.
You're killing me with her constant demands.
Better you than me.
Would you mind removing the hook from my eye? Smarts. You've heard of the arbitrary and capricious nature of unintended consequences.
Bet the new Pope hadn't. Or hubris? How about arrogance? Mm-hmm. Self-indulgence? Oh, never mind. This is good.
I'm not cruel by nature.
But this dunce has had more than his share of chances to redeem his stupidity.
Perhaps if you made her like God, she could at last be happy.
That's your idea of a solution to this problem? Well, I'm not surprised, but no doubt you will be. Shove what's left of my entrails back down my mouth and go home to your wife. You shall both have what you deserve.
Ignorant to the very end, she believes the fates have conspired against her. She is a blameless, pathetic wretch. fortune's fool, the plaything of wicked, unnatural forces. Never crossed her mind that her greed could be fed, but she could never be full. Those who expect a fair shake when they roll dice with enchanted fish are incurable optimists, unwitting masochists, or idiots. Mm-hmm. For this couple, I bet on the last. May all our stories end so well. Until next time.
And with that, we're going to call this here, so thanks for watching. See you later.
Yes, you can unlock the gallery.
Okay.
You get to see, yeah, you get to see, like what a lot of this stuff is, both light and dark.
Okay.
It just allows you to see, like, what it's...
Yep.
What everything looks. That's a nice little thing for
yep.
You know, it's experience.
With that, I'm going to call this episode here, so thanks for watching. See you later. See ya.
Bye.